and the microphone is on. And I'll just lay these up here, one and two. And you, and he'll call you by name.
That's a good microphone. He was picking up her voice when he got within a foot of it.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
So everybody knows. Everybody knows. But anyway, he'll call you each time.
Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. Welcome to Little Flower Parish here at St. Dismas Church. As we gather together this morning, we pray for the repose of the soul of our brother, John. It is with great sadness that we are gathered, and yet with great hope and consolation in God's love for us, we come and offer our prayers for John and the family. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, Lord be with you. In the waters of baptism, John died with Christ and rose with him to new life. May he now share with him eternal glory. In Christ, John found life and hope. In Christ, may he be clothed in glory.
Our entrance hymn is found in your Breaking Bread book, number 441, on Eagle's Wings, 441.
Dear friends, we have come together to renew our trust in Christ, who by dying on the cross has freed us from eternal death, and by rising has opened for us the gates of heaven. We pray for our brother John that he may share in Christ's victory, and we pray also for ourselves that the Lord may grant us the gift of his loving consolation. O God, Almighty Father, our faith professes that your Son died and rose again. Mercifully grant that through this mystery, your servant John, who has fallen asleep in Christ, may rejoice to rise again through him, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen. I'd like to invite you to please be seated. And we invite Deacon John Widmar to please come forward to proclaim the readings for us.
The first reading is a reading from the book of Ecclesiastes. There is an appointed time for everything, and a time for everything under the heavens. A time to be born, and a time to die. A time to plant, and a time to uproot the plant. A time to kill, and a time to heal. A time to fear, to tear down, and a time to build. A time to weep, and a time to laugh. A time to mourn, and a time to dance. A time to scatter stones, and a time to gather them up. A time to embrace, and a time to be far from embraces. A time to seek, and a time to lose. A time to keep, and a time to cast away. A time to rend, and a time to sow. A time to be silent, and a time to speak. A time to love, and a time to hate. A time of war, and a time of peace. The word of the Lord.
A responsorial psalm can be found in your Breaking Bread book, number 474, and you will be invited to join in on the refrain, "In Every Age," 474. Teach us to make use
of the time we have. Teach us to be patient even as we wait. Teach us to embrace our every joy and pain, to sleep peacefully, and to rise up strong in every age. Oh God, you have been our refuge. In every age, oh God, you have been our
This is a reading from the second letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, we know that if our earthly dwelling, a tent, should be destroyed, we have a building from God, a dwelling not made with hands, eternal in heaven. We are always courageous, although we know that while we are at home in the body, we are away from the Lord, for we walk by faith, not by sight. Yet we are courageous, and we would rather leave the body and go home to the Lord. Therefore, we aspire to please Him, whether we are at home or away. For we must all appear before the judgment seat of Christ, so that each may receive recompense according to what he did in the body, whether good or evil. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please stand.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ, King of endless glory.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ, King of endless glory.
I am the resurrection and the life, says the Lord. Whoever believes in me, even if he dies, will live. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ, King of endless glory.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. John. Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. You have faith in God. Have faith also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If there were not, would I have told you that I am going to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back again and take you to myself, so that where I am, you also may be. Where I am going, you know the way." Thomas said to him, "Master, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way?" Jesus said to him, "I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me." The Gospel of the Lord. Please be seated for a moment. There is appointed time for everything, a time for everything in their heavens. A time to be born, a time to die, a time to plant, and a time to uproot the plant. There was a time when we enjoyed, and certainly enjoyed, the friendship of John, his presence among us, his kindness, his generosity. I was talking to people before the funeral today, and somebody remarked, it's even difficult to find something negative to say about John. He was a very nice person, very kind, very generous with his time. Of course, we know of his smoked sausage. Everybody, I think, had a taste of it except me. But Deacon Bruce was telling me the very Good Friday, so it will be 2 days. It would have been 2 days. John would always bring his smoked sausage for Father Pat. And his sausage was not just for Father Pat, it was for everyone. Many ladies from the women's club was telling me today they had a taste of smoked sausage. And he was also very active here in this church. Now, he helped with the gardening. He was active with the Knights of Columbus. He was active with the men's club. I was still part of the men's club's parties, and John was always there. Of course, everybody knows, and Loretta is watching. Loretta was my polka partner. But they loved to polka. You know, it caught my eye earlier on the coffin there, that little thing that says polka something, right? They loved to polka. He loved to dance. Loretta and he married for 72 years. What a testimony of love and fidelity. A man of God, a man of faith. They came to this church. This was their area. And when John was no longer able to come to Loretta, accompanied by John, but he would be here for Mass. But he loved his faith. And I think he lived that faith not so much by preaching. Well, he preached it by his actions. He was there for everyone. He was kind to everybody. He always had a smile. He was fun to be with. He had a great sense of humor. And that was how he gave witness to the faith that he believed. And so, as we gather together this morning, yes, now we enjoy those times. Now we have come to mourn John's passing. I had the privilege of seeing him in the hospital and of anointing him, and we found out that he was diagnosed with cancer. And he maintained his serenity. Yes, at least during those times, even if he was in pain, John was always very calm. Time for everything, a time to be born, and a time to die. And dear brothers and sisters, as we come together today to honor this man and to pray for his repose, we come with gratitude for the life that he lived, the gifts that we shared, the gift that he was to all of us. And so, grateful to God for having allowed us John's friendship and his affection, his laughter. The Mass, as a matter of fact, is an act of thanksgiving. The Eucharist is an act of thanksgiving. And so we offer thanks to God for John's life and all that he was to all of us in this community. Grateful. And we come also, yes, certainly grieving, but our grief is overpowered by that great hope in the promise of the resurrection. We are on Holy Wednesday. We'll be celebrating the Triduum starting tomorrow, Holy Thursday, Good Friday, the death of Jesus, and then Easter, Jesus risen from the dead. And this is where our faith is founded. This is what fuels our hope. We believe that as Christians, there is life beyond this. John has preceded us. Now, that same God who loved John to life and sustained him in this life in love is the same God who called him back to himself in love. There is a beautiful reading from the letter of St. Paul in his letter to the Thessalonians that says, "We do not want you to be unaware about those who have fallen asleep, so that you may grieve like the rest who have no hope. For if you believe that Jesus died and rose from the dead, so too will God bring with him those who have fallen asleep." This is our faith. We die to this world, but we live in God forever. And the second reading today from St. Paul's letter to the Corinthians says, "We know that if our earthly dwelling, a tent, should be destroyed, we have a building from God, a dwelling not made with hands, eternal in heaven." And this will be echoed beautifully at the Mass today when we pray for God in death, for Christians in death. Life does not end. It is transformed. And while we lose what we have here on earth, we gain an everlasting dwelling with God in heaven. And so, St. Paul says, we are courageous. We aspire to please him. Because we know that whether we are away or at home, God is all in all for us. What can separate us? Again, St. Paul in his other letter, what can separate us from God's love for us, from Christ's love for us? Nothing can ever separate us. Because we belong to God in this world, we belong to God when we die. And so, yes, there is sadness. We mourn, but grateful and filled with hope in the Lord's promise of the resurrection. Many of you will remember the catechism of the Catholic faith, the old one. Why did God create me? God created me to know him and to love him and to serve him in this life, and to be happy with him in the next. Well, John strove to know God and to love him and to serve him in this life, in his brothers and sisters. What is left for him now is eternal glory promised to him and to all of us. And so we pray that the Lord may grant John eternal rest. And we ask Jesus, who is our life and resurrection, to come and fill the void that John has left in our hearts. John was a real Slovenian, as we all know that, inside, in and out, Slovenian, by heart and by everything. And so he carried with him that heritage, that faith. And so, my dear friends, brothers and sisters in Christ, now, the words of Jesus today from the gospel could well be the words of John for each one of us. "I am going, but I am going to prepare a place for you, so that where I am, you also may be." Now, I cannot resist the temptation of sharing this beautiful anecdote that many of our parishioners here have heard several times during our funerals. But it is regarding this older lady who was dying, and on her deathbed, she called in her pastor to be with her. And she asked him, "Father, will you please make sure that in my coffin I carry a fork with me?" And the pastor, "Why a fork?" "Well," she said, "because when I was still able, I used to go to restaurants. I loved restaurants." But she said, "After I finish, now the main course, and the servers would come and take all the dishes away. I always held on to my fork. Why? Because I knew that the best was yet to come." Of course, that was the dessert. Maybe those Slovenian cookies, right? And she said, "This life may be over, but I know that the best is yet to come." And for us Christians, what is better than eternal life in God's presence? Of course, This is a beautiful life with all its pains and conflicts and all the doubts and difficulties we may have. But this is a beautiful life. As a matter of fact, nobody speaks so eagerly about dying. And yet we also know that there is something beyond this, something greater than this, something no eye cannot see, ear has not heard, what God has in store for those who love Him, eternal life in God's presence. Our brother John has gone. We are left. We pray for him, and we pray for one another. We thank God for the gift that he was to us. And we ask Jesus to come and strengthen our faith in his promise of eternal life. Eternal life grant unto your servant, John, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon him. May he rest in peace. Amen. We now offer our prayers and our petitions. Please stand. Let us come to our loving Father, asking him to give eternal rest to the departed and comfort and hope to the living. For Brother John, that he may receive the happiness of eternal life promised in his baptism into Christ's church, let us pray to the Lord. We pray for the family of John, for Loretta, their children and grandchildren, and the whole family, that grief may be lightened by the risen Christ and his promise to unite us again in our heavenly home. Let us pray to the Lord. For the grace of a well-prepared death, that when the Lord comes, we will be ready with the lamp of faith, a light, and our baptismal robe unstained. Let us pray to the Lord. For the forgiveness of sins, that our prayers and the offering of this atoning sacrifice will bring all the departed to the full vision of God's glory. Let us pray to the Lord. God of our salvation, you reward the just and console those who mourn. Hear our prayers in the name of your risen Son who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. Please be seated.
Our preparation hymn is number 439, Be Not Afraid, 439. You shall cross the barren desert, but you shall not die of thirst. You shall wander far and safety, though you do not know the way. You shall speak your word in foreign lands, and all will understand. You shall see the face of God and
you shall not.
harmed. If you stand before the power of hell, and death is at your side, know that I am with you through it all. Be not afraid. I go before you.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy.
As we humbly present to you the sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of your servant John, we beseech your mercy that he who did not doubt your Son to be a loving Savior may find in him a merciful judge who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that though saddened by the certainty of dying, might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glorious without end we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest.
Please kneel if you're able. You are indeed holy, O Lord, a fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, He took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Blaise, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember your servant John, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that he who was united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
Amen, amen, amen. Please stand at the Savior's command. Informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
The kingdom,
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. Peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other a sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, not only worthy that you should enter into my room, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Dear brothers and sisters, as Catholics, we believe firmly that Jesus is present in the bread and wine consecrated during the Mass. He's here, body and blood, soul and divinity. In other words, in all his totality, Jesus is present, not as a mere symbol, but as a sacramental reality. John believed this firmly with all his heart. He came to this church regularly and received the body of Jesus, who promised him eternal life. We have now come to the point of Holy Communion. I would like to invite all practicing Catholics and who are prepared to please come forward to receive the body of the Lord. Our response is amen, confirming our faith in the real presence. Should there be any who is not able to receive communion and do not share our faith, if you wish to receive the blessing, please come to me and put your arms in front of you like this so that I may give you the blessing. If also those who are not able to come, you would like to receive communion but could not because of difficulty walking, if you can just let me know so that I can come to your place and give you communion. We form two lines in the middle.
And our communion hymn is number 342, "I am the bread of life," 342.
am the bread of life. You who come to me shall not hunger, and who believe in me shall not thirst. No one can come to me unless the Father beckons, and I will raise you up. And I will raise you up on the last day. The bread that I will give is my flesh for the life of the world. And if you eat of this bread, you shall live forever. And I will raise you up, and I will raise you up, and I will raise you up on the last day, unless you eat of the flesh of the Son of Man and drink of his blood, and drink of his blood, you shall not have life within you. And I will raise you up, and I will raise you up. And I will raise you up on the last day. I am the resurrection. I am the life. If you believe in me, even though you die, you shall live forever, and I will raise you up, and I will raise you up, and I will raise shall the memory linger on. O Jesus, carry me home. Carry me home, carry me home. O Jesus, carry me home. Carry me home, carry me home. O Jesus, carry me home. In God's hands to forever save me rest. O Jesus, carry me home. Now fulfilled in creation's wondrous plan. O Jesus, carry me home. Carry me home. Carry me home. O Jesus, carry me home. Carry me home. Carry me home. O Jesus, carry me home. Carry me home. Carry me home. Jesus, carry me home. Carry me home. Carry me home. Oh, Jesus, carry me home. As my last prayer ascends, round me family and gentle friends. Carry me home, carry me home. Oh Jesus, carry me home. Oh Jesus, carry me home.
Let perpetual light shine upon him with your saints forever, for you are merciful. Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon him with your saints forever, for you are merciful. Please stand and let us pray. Lord God, whose Son left us in the sacrament of his body food for the journey, mercifully grant that, strengthened by it, our brother John may come to the eternal table of Christ who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. Amen. Please be seated for a moment. Ed Cioda from the Knights of Columbus.
Thank you, Father. You know, it's my name's Ed. I'm from the Knights of Columbus. And it's really hard when we lose a knight, especially somebody like John, because he always was there. I don't think he ever had a bad bone or sad bone in him. You know, I mean, he always was willing to help. He always spoke good about his family. And I'm from, my heritage also is Polish, so we also had that in common, with polkas and sausage too. Of course, mine was kielbasa. So if you don't know what that is, well, you will now. So we used to kid around all the time, though. And it's just always, It's just hard to really with him because he was always so. I met him in church, and all the time. He's so grateful to everybody and everything. So now I'll read my resolution of condolence. In memory of Brother John whereas it has pleased Almighty God, his infinite wisdom, to call from our midst our beloved brother who departed this life, March the 22nd, the year of the Lord, 2024. And whereas by his death, our council sustained the loss of an exemplary Catholic gentleman and worthy knight of Columbus. Therefore, be it resolved that our departed brother be remembered daily in a special mass offered for the repose of souls of all deceased brother knights at St. Mary's Church, the birthplace of the order, in New Haven, Connecticut. Be it further resolved that while we bow in submission to the will of our Heavenly Father, we mourn the loss of our brother who has been taken from us, and be it further resolved that this testimonial of condolence, duly signed and sealed, be offered to the family of our departed brother knight as an expression of our heartfelt sympathy. Signed, Edward Trotta, Grand Knight, Richard Pignato, Deputy Grand Knight, and Daniel Anders, past Grand Knight. And I salute you, Brother John. May you rest and God bless. Thank you all. Thank you, Father.
Before the final commendation, I would like to thank Judy and Dave for the music, also the Grand Knight, Ed. And I'd like to thank our bereavement ministers, Bev and Mary Jo, and all our parishioners who have come to join us in today's celebration, and all of you. Thank you for being with us this morning. I'd like to assure the family of John our prayers for all of you, and also Loretta, who is watching us. God bless her. Please stand. Trusting in God, we have prayed together for Brother John, and now we come to the last farewell. There is sadness in parting, but we take comfort in the hope that one day we shall see him again and enjoy his friendship. Although this congregation will disperse in sorrow, the mercy of God will gather us together again in the joy of his kingdom. And so we console one another in the faith of our Lord Jesus Christ. The smoke that rises up as we incense the body of our brother John symbolizes our prayer lifted up to the Lord for his rest, and that he may be granted a joy in the kingdom of our Lord.
May the choirs of angels come to greet you. May they speed you to paradise. May the Lord enfold you in his mercy. May you find eternal life. May the choirs of angels come to greet you. May they speed you to paradise. May the Lord enfold you in his mercy.
into your hands. To you, O Lord, we commend the soul of John, your servant. In the sight of this world, he is now dead. In your sight, may he live forever. Forgive whatever sins he committed through human weakness, and in your goodness, grant him everlasting peace. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. May the angels welcome you. May the choirs of angels welcome you and lead you to the bosom of Abraham. And where Lazarus is poor no longer, may you find eternal rest. In peace, let us now take our brother John to his place of rest.
And our closing hymn is number 450, Amazing Grace, 450.
Amazing grace, how sweet
the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found, was thrown.